in the quest for sustainable aviation, there's been a shift in strategy by aviation giant Rolls-Royce. The company recently announced that it will be shifting its focus away from hydrogen propulsion technology as well as electric propulsion technology in favor of traditional propulsion technology. Now, this decision comes as the aviation industry are really looking for pathways toward sustainable aviation. Rolls-Royce CEO Tufan Erginbilgic cast doubt on the viability of hydrogen in aviation over the next 15 to 20 years. Despite advancements in hydrogen propulsion technology, there are still some major challenges to overcome. Hello, everyone. Thanks for checking out this video on cleanearth.io. My name is Mark Weich. Before we continue, I'd really appreciate it if you'd consider hitting that like and that subscribe button. By doing that, you're really helping us to improve what we do here, as well as grow our platform, and we simply appreciate it. Hydrogen, while it's a promising technology, comes with some challenges, and that is mainly related to infrastructure. Hydrogen requires large and heavy tanks for storage, and it also requires an overhaul of airport infrastructure for fueling. Electric propulsion, though it is advancing, is still limited by the weight and energy density of battery technology, making long-haul flights a challenge. Rolls-Royce had been working with Europe-based low-cost airline EasyJet on hydrogen technology, but Rolls-Royce has now shifted its focus and says that sustainable aviation fuel is the way forward in order for larger aircraft to achieve net zero climate targets. Erginbilgic believes that sustainable aviation fuel is the more immediate solution for the aviation industry to achieve its net zero climate targets. SAF can be integrated into existing airport infrastructure while offering significantly lower carbon emissions than traditional jet fuel. Rolls-Royce strategy includes divesting its electric business unit for electric propulsion aircraft. That will offer the company some savings in the near term, and it also allows the company to focus its efforts on conventional propulsion technology, which they believe will dominate aviation for the next two decades. Rolls-Royce position contrasts heavily with that of the other aviation giant, Airbus. The company continues to invest heavily in hydrogen propulsion technology, aiming for operational readiness by 2035. The divergence in strategies between these two aviation giants really underscores the different perspectives across the aviation industry in terms of achieving sustainable aviation. This strategic shift by Rolls-Royce really raises some key questions about the aviation industry and its path toward sustainability. Is SAF the way forward for the industry to be able to achieve net zero carbon emissions, or should there be continued investment in hydrogen propulsion technology? The other major question is, how will the aviation industry overcome these technological and infrastructure challenges? So even with SAF, there still needs to be the ramp up of SAF production in various markets and for airlines in order to meaningfully scale the fuel type to make a significant reduction in carbon emissions from aircraft. Several airlines are increasing the use of SAF to power their flights, but given the scale of the aviation industry, SAF only represents a small percentage of the amount of fuel used across the aviation industry, in some cases, less than 1%. And beyond the airlines, there still needs to be the infrastructure for SAF in order to use it at the type of scale to meaningfully impact the carbon emissions from the aviation industry. Share your thoughts on this shift in strategy by Rolls-Royce. Do you think that the focus on conventional propulsion technologies is the way forward, or is there another path that should be considered by an aviation giant like Rolls-Royce and others? Also, what is your view on the role of achieving net zero in the aviation industry and how the industry can become more sustainable in a meaningful way? Be sure to leave your comments in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the like button. And if you didn't, let us know how we can do better. Also, for more updates like this from us, be sure to hit that subscribe button. We'll see you in the next video soon. Thanks for watching.